Today, I'm going to show you how to create a slide that shows annual sales revenue of an organization with 6 locations across 6 geographies. So let's start with a blank slide and quickly change the background color of the slide. Then head over to Insert, click on Pictures and insert a wall map, which will serve as our canvas for highlighting sales locations. Before we continue, let's resize the map slightly for a better fit. The white color of the map is okay, but I think we can make it more legible. So let's head over to graphics format and let's go for lavender. Yeah, it looks better. Now that our map is ready, let's mark the 6 locations where the sales occurred. And to do that, I'll go over to shapes, click on oval, hold down shift key and draw a small circle. Let's zoom in. Click on shape outline and choose no outline. Open shape fill and change the fill color to red. Let's reduce the size of the circle and move it to the first location, and that is New York. Now we can press Ctrl or Command plus D to duplicate the circle and move it to the next location, which is London. I think we should reduce the size of the circle a bit more and replace the one for London. That's better. Open shape fill and change its color to turquoise. Now you know the drill, let's jump to the 6th location, and that is Rio de Janeiro. With all the 6 locations now identified on the map, it's time to introduce a callout showing the revenue associated with each location. First, let's create the callout on a new slide, and when we are done, we can move it over to the first slide. Open shapes and click on rounded rectangle. Draw a rectangle, adjust its corners just a little bit. Now let's click on triangle. Press down shift key and draw a small triangle. Head over to rotate and select flip vertical. Resize the triangle and move it below the rectangle. Make sure it's in the center. Hold down shift key and click on the triangle and rectangle. Then head over to mesh shapes and select union. Now they have become one shape. Go to shape outline and select no outline. Open shape fill and choose white color. We can't see the shape right now because of the background color of the slide. So right click on the slide, then on format background and change the background color. Now we can see the shape, but we are not done yet. To make a callout even more striking, go to shape format, click on shape effect, then open shadow and select bottom right. Right click on the shape and open format shape, then click on effect. Let's increase blur to about 12 points. The angle looks good at 45 degrees. For the distance, let's increase it to about 6 points. Reduce size to 97%. That looks okay. And for transparency, let's take it up to 70%. Awesome. I think we can work with this. Go to shapes and click on text to add sales figure for the first location. Let's enter $43,670 and change its font to Montserrat, size to 12 point and make the text bold. The callout appears to be large for a 12 point text, so let's resize it and see how it works with the text. To provide additional context, let's add another text. Use the same font. Give it a size of 7 points. Bold the text and change its color to something grayish. Let's place the text above the figure and make some final adjustment to the size of the callout shape. For added visual appeal, we can include an icon to the left of this callout. To do this, let's head over to Insert and click on Icon. You can use any icon of your choosing. Now let's reduce its size to fit into the space available. It looks good right there. Let's bring the icon out. Go to Insert, Shapes, and click on Rounded Rectangle. We want to add a rounded rectangle as a backdrop for the icon. Right-click and send it to back. Let's increase its rounded edges a bit more. Resize and position it properly. There you go. Click on Shape Fill and change its fill color to lemon. Open Shape Outline and click on No Outline. Select the icon and change its fill color to white and Graphics Outline to white as well. Now we can select both the icon and rectangle, group them and place them within the callout. Let's make sure it fits. Bingo! Our callout is ready. Select everything on it, click on Arrange and select Group. And now we can use it on the first slide. Right-click and copy it. Then go over to the first slide and paste it. Let's move it to the first location, New York. Open Shapes and click on Text. Then type New York. Select Montserrat. Use 10 points for font size and make it bold. Then move the text to the position for New York. It's all coming together. We don't need slide 2 anymore, so let's delete it. Back on slide 1, let's duplicate the callout and move it over to the position for London. Let's change the figure. Select the font and click on the replace icon that appears to the right and choose a different icon. Now we can duplicate this text, move it here and change it to London. Before we move to the next location, let's change the color of this rectangle from green to red. Bingo! At this point, all we have to do is repeat these steps for remaining 4 locations. So let's skip over to the last location. And now we have provided sales figures for all the locations. With our callout in place, let's connect all 6 locations together using a line. Click on Shapes and select Curve. Let's start from Dubai. I'll click. Then move the mouse to London. Click again and move to New York and double click to finish. And that's our first connector. Now let's do from Sydney to Dubai and to Rio. And finally from Tokyo to Dubai. We have to ensure the line appears behind the location markers. So let's click on the first one. Go to Arrange and select Bring to Front. Repeat the steps for the rest of the markers. Let's do the same thing for the callouts that are behind the lines. And just before we conclude, let's right click on this line and click on Format Shape. Underline, check gradient and delete one gradient stop. Now let's select the first stop. Open color and select red color. Move to the second stop and choose purple. And for the last stop, let's go for blue. I think it looks fantastic. Now we just need to copy this gradient with Ctrl or Command plus Shift plus C, select another line and apply the effect with Ctrl or Command plus Shift plus V. Then repeat for the third line. Ladies and gentlemen, I think our sales revenue slide is ready to rock and roll. In the second part of this tutorial, We will explore animation to reveal further details for each location, so stay tuned for that. And that's it for now. Thank you, and please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already.